This is the swarm trap that I'm using this year. In my last video, I went through some of the mistakes that I made last year and why the trap that I used last year didn't catch any swarms. In this video, I'm going through why I chose this design, some of the features that I like about it, how I'm planning on using it, and then what the cost of putting these together was. I got the plans for this trap from horizontalhive.com, where he has the plans laid out for anyone who wants to use them. He's got a couple of different designs on there, depending on what type of hive you run. This is the one that's built for the Langstroth frames. You could use deep, medium, really anything. I've linked all of the different plans in the description below. If you're interested in building this for yourself, you can go down and check that out. I like that this design has a telescoping lid. This was very easy to make. It also means that it's going to be watertight. This is metal flashing that goes over the top, runs over the sides. You can see that it takes 6 Langstroth frames. Some of the other designs go from 5 to 7 on the website, but the Langstroth fits 6. Now, there is some give in here, and what I don't want is to install it and have something weird happen, like a space in the middle. What I'm going to do is put nails in on each side to keep these frames in place. You can really use whatever type of frame you want. I have plastic foundation in here right now. It's more likely that I'll put this up with foundationless frames. These frames only go about halfway down, which leaves all of this open, empty space. I added this to the design. One of the notes on the plan was to lean this forward when installing it, so that rainwater didn't go into the entrance. If rain hits this face of the trap, I want it to roll down and off. I don't want there to be any way that it's going to roll in and make this entrance wet. I have not put any drainage holes underneath. If you wanted to, you could put a small drainage hole in each corner to let rainwater roll out if some did get in there, but my goal is to keep rainwater out entirely. In my last video, one of the mistakes that I mentioned is that I only put out one trap. I have 5 of these that I've built. They all need to be painted, but otherwise they're ready to go in a tree. There is no hanging apparatus with this. The idea is that you find a tree with some sort of branch that you can use to support the weight, and then you use a ratchet strap to attach it to the trunk to keep it vertical. With frames, this one is weighing in at 18 pounds. I'm going to write that underneath the trap so that whenever I take it out of a tree, I can weigh it and I can get the weight of the swarm. These are not all going up in my yard. They're gonna go up around town in the backyards of friends. My goal for these is to have them spaced out around town, maybe a mile or so apart. In total, I've spent about $100 for 5 traps. My average cost is coming out to $20 per trap. If I have a 20% success rate on these traps, they will have paid for themselves and then some. Most of the cost was in the 2 sheets of plywood that I need. After that, the next largest cost is in a 10-foot roll of flashing. If you've built these traps or one that's similar, leave a comment below. Let us know what your success has been with those. I'm really curious to see how these do after having no success last year. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, please like and subscribe so that you don't miss any of the future ones. Thanks for watching.